It's the night before the big race, and while most of the sailors are doing their last-minute checks and preparations, the rest of us get to enjoy a cruise of Victoria Harbour, and of course, dinner after.
Hong Kong is a local name for Fragrant Harbour, a name inspired by the precious incense that used to be traded here. Over the centuries, and up till today, Hong Kong has remained one of the world's top commercial ports, with the wealth from finance and trade used to build a spectacular skyline on both sides of the harbor.
Yes, this is how you do it. Surely anyone who's been to Hong Kong has probably tried one of the ferries that take you from one side of the harbor to the other, or one of those popular tourist boats. But if you want to cruise Victoria Harbor in style, this is the way you do it. In a proper yacht like this one. This is really amazing. Not just the sunset, but also the weather. It's the first time the sun is out in days. A lot of sailors were nervous about the race tomorrow and the weather that was expected. Well, maybe things will change for the better.
Which only makes tomorrow's race more unpredictable, since most teams set up their race strategy expecting bad weather. The cruise ends where the next day's race begins, at the Royal Hong Kong Yacht Club, where most of the boats in competition are docked for the night.
So it's not just the sailors who are getting ready for tomorrow's big race, so are those boats over there. So let's just leave them alone, let them get some rest, because they've got a big day tomorrow.
Like sailors everywhere in the world, the night before a journey is often spent merrily away. But with the latest weather report just in, some teams are still meeting.
So I just bumped into Albert and his crew downstairs, and they were doing some last-minute discussions on what to do tomorrow for the race. I asked him, what's the best way for sailors to prepare for a big race of Halloween Day? And he said, just get a good night's sleep, a proper mental condition. So while they're all asleep, I'm gonna party. This is a Rolex gala dinner.
So yes, while we guests stay awake, feast, dance the night away, I can only wonder what's going through the minds of those sailing the following day, and what the latest report forecasts to be, inclement weather over the harbor.
So in just about 2 hours, the teams here will be setting sail from Victoria Harbor to Subic Bay in the Philippines, in what is one of the most challenging sea routes in Asia. Well, let's find out how Hurricane Hunter is doing. Let's go.
There's a mix of excitement and trepidation in the air. Most of these sailors have been through this routine before, yet most still admit race day jitters anyway.
So here we go. Years, months of preparation. It's race day. What goes through your mind at a moment like this?
A lot of things. Obviously, the excitement is there. The anxiety of how you will do in the race in general, and also what the winds and the waves will do. That's also causing some anxiety, but it's a good feeling. We're really looking forward to getting on the starting line and getting down to business.
Getting down to some last-minute business means prepping the boats for the 3 to 5 journey ahead, depending on the direction of the wind.
When the winds are light, it's about lightening up your weight. And when the winds are strong, it's the opposite.
With light to almost no wind expected approaching Subic, boats only carry the most basic necessities. As you can see, no luxuries, and no beds at all. Even CEOs on the team take turns sleeping on the floor.
Well, I'll tell you right now, there's 8 people, 2 shifts, so at any given time, there's only 4 people sleeping. So we're swapping bunks, really. So two people here, one on the, that becomes a bed.
But you guys are used to it, so.
Yeah.
You know.
I'm used to his.
It's snoring.
Yeah, exactly.
When the race about to start, sailors take turns belting out their loudest cheers to boost morale and calm the nerves.
Hurricane Hunter!
And after a few more ceremonial speeches and the traditional lion dance for good luck, boats take off for the starting line in the middle of the harbor.
So the countdown begins in about 5 minutes from now. We're going to hear the starting gun, officially starting the race to Subic Bay. Let's wait for that.
In his final crucial minutes, the boats circle the harbor, careful not to be too far from the starting line when the gun goes off. With many watching, you want to be seen in first place here.
And there they go. The race has begun, and so far, our Philippine teams are doing pretty well. In fact, one of our boats is in the lead right now. The other boat is in third place, and just look at that. They're catching up. They'll be second place soon. For Hurricane Hunter, well, they've fallen a bit behind, but it's a long race to Subic Bay. A lot of time to catch up.
Trent!
As you can see, some boats are larger than others. The ones with larger sails, like the Philippine Centennial 5 and Centennial 3, and Rampage of Hong Kong, take the early lead. But their size is also a handicap, with time deducted when computing the overall winner of the race. Which means the smaller, slower boats trailing behind may have a better chance of winning overall honors if they manage to stay close enough to the leaders. Which is exactly how the race unfolded, with Ernesto Echauza's Centennial 5 crossing the finish line at Subic first, and a day ahead of the field to win the trophy for line honors.
It's so fantastic because it's the first time that the Philippine boat won the line honors in a China series, a Rolex China series.
But it was a smaller Whiskey Jack of Hong Kong, skippered by Nick Salford, that was the overall winner of the 2023 race on corrected time, after handicaps were considered. Yeah! As for Hurricane Hunter, they managed to beat expectations as well, finishing fifth overall in their first Rolex China Sea Race.
Hurricane Hunter!
In the end, however, there are no losers, because the experience of being out in the water makes anyone who tries sailing feel like a winner.
For me, I just love getting out in the ocean for a start. I mean, there's nothing quite like when you get away from it all and you're in that large, expansive ocean. Night sailing, racing, it's beautiful. You don't need fireworks and things like that. You just look up at the sky and you've got everything you want. It's amazing.
That's all for this episode of Executive Class. I'm David Saldran in Hong Kong. Thanks for watching.